Next generation firewalls are more than just a list of access control entries. They look deeper into traffic to find additional threats. On a Palo Alto firewall, a key component to this is the security profile. We use a security profile to match traffic based on conditions like source, destination, user, application, and so on. If the conditions match, and if the action allows traffic, then we can apply a security policy. This looks for additional threats within this traffic. These threats include viruses, malware, vulnerabilities, risky file types, and DOS attacks. We can also use these profiles for data loss prevention and for wildfire. For example, we may have a security policy that allows some web browsing traffic and blocks others. We wouldn't apply any security profiles to the rule that drops traffic. However, on the rule that allows traffic, we might apply antivirus, anti-spyware, and URL filtering profiles. While the rule allows web browsing, these profiles look at things like whether the URL is safe and suitable for work, and whether any files that are downloaded are malicious. If there's a threat, the security profile can drop the traffic. WildFire is Palo Alto's secure cloud-based sandbox environment that's used to check unknown files and email links for threats. These files and links are sent to the cloud to be scanned. A result of malicious, grayware, benign, or phishing is then sent back to the firewall. Signatures are created for malicious and phishing traffic, so other firewalls can block these files quickly. I have another video on WildFire if you'd like to know more about how that works. The default WildFire security profile is suitable in most cases. However, sometimes you might want to configure additional profiles to better handle traffic between trusted zones. An antivirus profile protects endpoints within your network from virus-related threats from outside the network. It does this using a stream-based malware prevention engine. This basically means that the firewall looks at a stream of traffic and uses a decoder to understand the traffic type and check it for viruses, trojans, worms, and so on. These decoders can look at FTP, HTTP, HTTP2, IMAP, POP3, SMB, and SMTP. I'd like to stress that while this aims to stop viruses before they reach the endpoint, this is not a replacement for installing antivirus software on your endpoints. There are other ways viruses can slip through. Within the profile settings, we can change the action per decoder. This could be allow, alert, drop, and reset. The default profile is good, but you might consider creating a custom profile to minimize effort on the firewall side when traffic is passing between trusted zones, or to maximize protection from an untrusted zone. Additional protection is available through WildFire, which enables the decoders to use signatures to check for well-known threats, as well as evasive and emerging threats. Anti-spyware profiles are kind of the reverse to an antivirus profile. They look for clients within the network that appear to be compromised. Why is this important? Because compromised clients will try to connect to command and control servers where a malicious person or bot will try to take over. This profile detects this type of traffic and blocks it. There are two built-in profiles named Default and Strict. The default profile will use the default action for each signature as defined by Palo Alto. The strict profile overrides this and blocks all critical, high, and medium threats and will alert on low and informational traffic. Each profile contains a set of rules. Each rule contains a threat name, which is a filter to match signatures, a category, which is a type of threat like a keylogger or command and control, an action, and a severity level. In addition to the regular actions like allow, alert, and drop, we have default, which is the Palo Alto recommended action. We have block IP, which temporarily blocks traffic from this source IP, and DNS sinkhole. DNS sinkhole is where the firewall forges a DNS response to clients that access a malicious domain. This makes it easier for us to identify compromised hosts. Vulnerability protection goes hand in hand with anti-spyware. While anti-spyware looks at traffic leaving the network, vulnerability protection looks at traffic entering the network. In particular, it looks at traffic that is known to exploit security flaws. For example, it will detect traffic that tries to gain access to systems, overflow buffers, execute code, and things like this. This also contains a set of rules, like the name, which is a signature filter, an action, the host type, category, CVE, vendor ID, and severity. It's nice that you can filter by the CVE number or vendor if you want to get specific. You could even do this to create exceptions if you want. As with anti-spyware, there are two default profiles that you can use, strict and default. URL filtering is easy to understand. It's simply a way to monitor and control how users access the web. Websites are sorted into categories like adult, hacking, news, and so on. There are a lot of different categories. The default profile blocks malicious sites and adult content. When you create a security policy, you will allow web traffic. A URL filtering profile can then be attached to further refine the web filtering. File blocking is a simple profile that stops certain types of files from being transferred. Generally, these will be files like executables, scripts, and other types that are known to be risky. This even allows us to configure a custom web page that warns the user, but gives them the opportunity to download the file anyway. This can be done by setting the continue action. As is often the case, there are two out-of-the-box profiles, basic and strict, or you can create your own. Data filtering profiles are quite interesting. These are used as a type of DLP, or data loss prevention. The idea is to prevent sensitive information from leaving the network. The profile looks for patterns in traffic that may indicate that someone is sharing a credit card number, a social security or tax file number, or some other pattern that you configure. In addition to looking for a regex pattern, we can specify the file type to inspect, for example a Word doc, as well as the type of traffic, such as FTP. That's the basics of Palo Alto profiles. I hope it wasn't too dry for you. There's more coming up, so please stick around for the next video.